about Islamophobia. Webster defines Islamophobia as an irrational fear of or hatred of Islam or Muslims. But I guess most of the people in this room already know that. And I want to bring your attention to Islamophobia in our state and to the consequences of it. This is the state that last year experienced the bombing of Darul Farooq Mosque. Recently, the perpetrators were arrested, and we learned and discovered that the bombers, the terrorists, were from Chicago. They're not from Minnesota. And this is important and significant for us for the following reason. In February of this year, two elected officials, Representative Kathy Lohmer from Stillwater and Representative Cindy Pugh from Chanhassen, forwarded Islamophobic material on Facebook. And they accused Muslims of trying to take over America. Muslims, you see, are caught between a rock and a hard place. If they don't participate, they are said to be, these people refuse to integrate. If they participate, they are accused of taking over. The actions of Representative Pugh and Representative Lohmer went viral. 300,000 people watched those videos, and we have received 10,000 pieces of hate mail from her supporters, including death threats. Now, if a death threat is made by somebody in Alabama or Texas, somebody might have said, well, that is not important. But the case of the Darul Farooq bombing proves otherwise. We take each and every one of those death threats seriously. And we hold Representative Lohmer and Representative Pugh personally responsible for them. We call upon them to apologize on the floor of the House of Representatives for these actions they have taken that have hurt the people they were elected to represent, and that have hurt the civic fabric of the state. I sent a letter requesting to the two of them that we need to talk about this. They sent me back a letter saying they only meet with constituents. I then started calling Muslims in their district, and in each of their cases, we found constituents who wanted to make an appointment with them. I want this point to be clear. I want the media to report this. In the case of Representative Pugh, she made an appointment and this morning canceled it. This is unacceptable. We are going to come back again and again and ask for an in-person meeting. You will have to face the voters whom you supposedly represent. They will ask you to apologize. You will have that. Yes. Majority leader and the speaker, I got the same nonsense. This is not acceptable. The speaker needs to represent the entire state. In the case of the speaker, furthermore, if he insists, I do not mind visiting his district and finding constituents, Muslim or Christian or Jewish or a person of no faith, as long as they are persons of goodwill, I don't mind finding those people and bringing them one by one to the legislature. I will do that if that is what I'm compelled to do. This matter is serious. I ask all our allies, if you are a priest, if you are a bishop, if you are a rabbi, if you are a person of faith or if you are a person of no faith, as long as you are a person of goodwill, please call the speaker's office and ask for a meeting for yourself, not for me, at a time that is convenient for you. Call the speaker's office and say, we would like to meet with you about Islamophobia and the culture of hate. When can we have a meeting? If you are from their district, please call me. I want to talk to you. I want to set this up correctly. This has to stop. The words have consequences. There has already been a bombing, and the people are being radicalized with fear and hate, and the people who are doing that need to be called out. I call on all elected officials to call this out. Thank you very much.